Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. It is me, Gavieta, back again with another video. And for today's video, I thought I would kind of explain how I began teaching in South Korea. Because if you didn't know, I am a teacher here in South Korea. I live in Daegu, which is I think the fourth largest city in South Korea. But yes, so I live in Daegu, I teach. And I want to show you guys how you can teach in South Korea. It is not as hard and unobtainable as, and I'm an English teacher and I can't even pronounce words, but it is not that hard to do it. Really, there's just a few requirements. So I'm going to talk about the requirements. I'm going to talk about the different steps as well. But before I start getting into the requirements and the different steps, definitely hit that subscribe button. It would be much appreciated. And also hit the notification button too, so that you guys can be notified when I post new videos here in Korea. So if you're thinking about teaching in South Korea, there are two different ways. You can go through a public school, which is probably through EPIC. I'm not too sure about EPIC because I didn't go with EPIC. I actually teach at a Hagwon, which is a private school. So, well, private academy that's just for learning English. Yeah, I went through Hagwon. I applied through Dave's Isol Cafe. I will talk more about Dave's Isol Cafe, but there are two different ways you could teach, private or public school. As for their requirements, you need to be a native English speaker from an English-speaking nation, which means you have to be from the United States, the UK, Ireland, New Zealand, South Africa, or Australia. You have to have a bachelor's degree. It does not matter what your major was. My major was humanities. I did not major in English or even in teaching for that matter. So it doesn't matter what your major is, just as long as you have a bachelor's degree. Next, you have to have a clear criminal background check, like FBI background check, like a big background check, clear, because obviously they don't want convicted felons or convicted people to be around children and teaching them. So you have to have a clear background check. So hopefully you didn't do anything too crazy. As for testing and certificates, some schools or programs require you to have a TEFL, TESOL, or CELTA certificate, which is basically a certificate that you complete a number of hours in training for teaching. I never got a TEFL. My school didn't require it, my program didn't require it, so I never got it. I'm sure it would help you if you did get it. It could be kind of expensive, and I also didn't know at first if I actually wanted to teach, so I just never did it, and here I am. I can still teach. I did not need to have my TEFL. Before you apply though, it's good to get your background check and bachelor's degree apostilled. You will hear the word apostille document a lot, especially when you're coming to South Korea. I don't know about other countries if they require it to be apostilled, but South Korea definitely does require it to be apostilled. Basically, apostille is like a more extensive notary. When you're doing your apostilled bachelor's degree, that comes from the state. Before you get your degree apostilled, it needs to be notarized. You could do that directly through your college. My college, it was $20 to get that notarized. And then once it's notarized, then you send that document off to the Secretary of State, which I'm from Florida, so my Secretary of State was in Tallahassee, so I just mailed it over. I did overnight shipping because I just did overnight shipping. I'm not too sure how much that was. Maybe like $20 to overnight it, but to get it apostilled by the Secretary of State, I don't know how much it costs. Definitely, maybe it was around $20. If I'm wrong, I'll put it on the screen, but it costs money to get your stuff apostilled. And it took about a month for me to get my degree back in the mail after it went to the Secretary of State. As for my background check, most FBI cleared background fingerprint companies offer different services for you to get it apostilled. You could go through them, but I feel like sometimes going through them is a lot more expensive. Sometimes it could be up to $250 to get it apostilled through that service, but I sent it off to the actual company. The faster you want it back, the more the price. It ranges from around $80 to $200 to get a FBI apostilled background check. The actual fingerprinting process for the FBI background clearance was $60 for me. I'm sure different places cost different, but you could go on the FBI background check website, and they'll show you the approved places that you can go to. It definitely has to be approved, so don't get into any scams. It has to be approved by the FBI. So once you get all your apostille things, usually it takes a month for those two documents to come back. Also takes maybe a week for you to send it off, depending if you're overnighting it or just sending it through postal mail. So you could either get those documents apostilled before or after you applied, but you're definitely gonna need it, so you might as well just start right away. As for a little side note, the FBI background check only is good for 6 months. So if you're not looking to go within the first, like, the 6 months, definitely wait till it's a little closer, because what happened to me was I got my background checked super far advance. It ended up expiring. Then I needed to get another one and pay again. So if you're not thinking about going to Korea within the 6 months of your background check, definitely wait on that so it doesn't expire. As for where and how to apply, you can apply directly through Epic. If you want to do Epic, that's a public school thing. They put you anywhere in South Korea. You don't really have a say on where you get placed. If you want to know more about that, just search up Epic on YouTube and Epic South Korea and you'll find some more videos. I didn't do that, so I won't be talking on that. I went through a Hagwon. For Hagwon, you can apply directly through the Hagwon, or you could go through recruiters. And I found my recruiter on Dave's Isol Cafe. So Dave's Isol Cafe, you just go on the website, search up jobs in South Korea, and then you'll find all the job listings. It's kind of like Indeed. So it'll show you all the jobs, what those jobs are looking for, what grades you're teaching, where the job is. So I kind of just looked through them. I applied through a whole lot when you're applying. It just requires you to send a picture and your resume to this email. Then they'll get in touch. They'll usually schedule a video call and tell you more about the position. Then they'll schedule an actual interview. Sometimes it's one interview. Sometimes you have two separate interviews. It just depends on the job that you're looking for. I applied to so many. I had so many video calls. But definitely, if you're thinking about moving to South Korea, it was a huge change. So don't apply to just one. Definitely dip your toes in the water, see how many options there are out there, see what the best option is for you, see what the schools are offering. Some schools offer to pay your entire flight there and back. Some schools offer only their flight there. Some schools don't even offer for them to pay your flight. So there are different benefits, I guess. So definitely check that. Some schools pay different also. Definitely be aware of that and asking what benefits while you're on your interview, just so that you know what you're getting into, since it's such a big change. When you email them, they'll ask you to fill out some paperwork. Sometimes you need to take kind of like an SAT test. It's not that big of a deal. It's like 10 questions. You send them your answers. If you pass and they like your score, then they'll interview you. Some schools don't do that. And in the interview, if you want to know in depth about the interview, definitely, and maybe I'll make a video on that in the future, they basically ask very standard interview questions like, oh, why do you want to teach? Why do you want to go to South Korea? What makes you a good teacher? Have you ever experienced a problem with a student? What's your teaching experience? You don't need teaching experience. That's another thing. You don't need to have been a teacher or even taught or volunteered as a teacher. There is no teaching requirements for most of the programs. If you have taught, sometimes you could say during your interview, hey, I've already have teaching experience, can I raise the pay up a little bit? So definitely ask that during your interview too, if you do have experience. Some of the documents you'll have to fill out are preferred age range, preferred location. Some schools have multiple locations, like the school I'm with has over 180 different schools all across Korea. So sometimes you could just apply directly to the Hagwon. Maybe they have different locations, so definitely location of preference. After you've done all your interviews, you've selected what program or what school you want to be with, you get sent a contract. And definitely look over this contract, print it out, look it over, highlight any questions, because the contract is where they get you. The contract will tell you the dates of your stay, the pay, expectations, what to do, what not to do, vacation time, if any. What days you don't go to school, like holidays. Look at it very carefully before signing it. Ask your recruiter about any questions you have. Definitely don't sign the contract if you have any questions or if you're unclear about certain areas. ask your recruiter, ask the school. Don't sign the contract if any part of it is questionable, because they will hold that contract against you. Don't feel like you have to sign the first contract that you get. Sometimes if you have multiple interviews, multiple schools will send you a contract. You don't have to sign the first one you get. There will be many options for you. There's tons of school in Korea, so if you don't like that first contract, don't be afraid that that might be your only option to get here. There are many other options. Don't be afraid to not sign your first one. I did not sign my first one. I went through maybe 3 different contracts, signed the third one. So don't be afraid not to sign the first one. Unless your first one's like the perfect school, perfect scenario for you, go ahead and sign it, but don't be afraid not to. There will be other opportunities to teach. Okay, you signed your contract, ready to go. What are the next steps? That's why I went with a recruiter. She helped me along the process, super easy. So next, you'll probably have to send over all your documents to either the school directly or to your recruiter. Then your recruiter will send that over to the school. Also, scan all your documents just in case. It's good just to have a scan of all the documents just in case you lose it or just in case you might need to look at it later. Send those documents over. They'll send you a list of what to send over, how to do it, all of that. Send those documents over to either your school or your recruiter. They'll take care of that. You're gonna need some passport pictures. Probably around 6 of them. And passport pictures at Walgreens, hella expensive. That's what I went through. So it was $14.99 for 2. So I had to pay like 3 times that because I needed 6. Send all the documents over that they told you to send over. You just wait for the company to send you back your visa number. So once they send you the visa number, takes maybe about a month, maybe longer, maybe shorter, depends on your circumstances, but you wait for a visa number. Okay, that visa number came, it'll come in an email. Then you need to apply for your E2 visa through your Korean consulate. My consulate was in Atlanta. You don't have to go in person. I mailed all my stuff over, and the consulate website will give you all the regions that they're in for each consulate if you don't have one in your state. So once you mail them the documents that you need, like your visa application, your passport, obviously, because they need to put your visa in somewhere, and your passport pictures, then you just wait for the documents to come back. It takes about 2 to 4 weeks. For me, I applied through COVID, so it took like 6 weeks, I believe, to get it back. And once you get that, you can book your flight and you're good to go. And then some schools offer online or in-person training for when you get to Korea, but after that you're ready to go, and then you start your journey with your school. Each school does training differently, if they train you at all. So yeah, you're ready to go to South Korea. I hope that was helpful. I'll put some of the websites down below which you might need, and I will put Dave's Easel Cafe down below. If you have any questions or you want me to go in very specifically about any of the steps, just let me know down in the comments. I hope this video was helpful. I will also probably link some other videos that you could look at that might talk more in depth about other stuff or just are also good to look at. I watched tons of YouTube videos before I came here. It definitely helped me a lot. I hope this video helps you a lot. Don't forget to subscribe. And I hope if you're coming to South Korea, I hope you enjoy it. So yes, that is the end of this video.